Well, it does leave the Phoenix in the pool, but teams IG feel they may have a solution for it. Sniper is still out there. Cloud9 not going to ban it. And they change it up even more. IG going to steal the Zeus away. First overall pick.
Just start taking heroes of Cloud9's.
Well, the Cloud9 want the Sniper? That's the question now. Sniper Phoenix is available. The one good thing with Zeus is he has really heavy burst. So if you get any stuns on the Phoenix, you can quite possibly just kill him before he even gets to Supernova. Yeah.
Now, Cloud9, the losses this tournament comes often when Fata's not an accompanied hero. They had to run Bristleback in the mid lane a few times. I don't know if it's an uncomfortable hero for him, but it's definitely not a go-to. It's like the last resort type pick for Fata. We saw a TA from him as well.
I feel like it's less that Fata's not good on the hero and more that the team doesn't play around him as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
This feels like a hero that I almost never see IG play, by the way. It's the Zeus, do they...
It's not really.
I've seen them run it very infrequently and normally as a support, I feel, rather than a
three
mid.
Picks in total this tournament. Okay, that's more than I would.
That's
thought.
Across the group stage as well, online, yeah. That's out of maybe like 20 games, I guess.
It generally seems like the Chinese teams favor the support Zeus. We don't see all that much core.
And this is the expected response. Sniper's still in the pool, you take that, you get the Phoenix. Generally, it's Envy on the Sniper in a side lane role, but I mean, if Cloud9 decide the draft calls for it, I'm sure they're comfortable putting it mid lane for Envy or Fata as well.
Only a 50% win rate. It's not been a particularly dominant hero for Cloud9.
The Sniper?
Yeah. Oh, that's what the stats are saying.
Oh, I see. Yeah, okay.
What do IG want? They picked their Zeus early. 430s, go-to heroes. The Storm, the Queen of Pain banned out. Don't know if there's any other... Oh, Shadow Fiend would be the big one if they wanted a classic 430 hero.
But that already puts their Zeus more or less in a support role. Yeah. Unless they want to safe lane the Shadow Fiend or off lane Zeus on Dire, which I think could end up being...
We've seen the Lion a lot for Chuan, the Earthshaker as well. Probably their two, I think, most favored supports as far as picking it early. Gods mentioned last game, the Rubick for Chuan has been a go-to at times. We've also seen the Ancient Apparition. A decent amount could go well with the Zeus if they want to run more of a global strat. But I don't know if you want to pick both of them up in this first phase. It reveals quite a bit about your overall game plan.
I'm wondering if there's... playing with the thought of picking Troll. But I feel like that would be a mistake.
I don't.
Troll just seems not to match up against Sniper.
Yeah, and it doesn't seem a super Burning-esque hero.
I think the Jug is more comfortable for Burning if they want to go for one of the big carries of this pack.
So they get a solid support. This can work as a support duo with the Zeus or just, I mean, if it's any support duo, whether it's 4-position line, 5-position line, it's just always a good pick.
I do like these heroes a lot versus Phoenix, though. Extremely heavy burst. You get a single stun, and Phoenix is not getting off that Supernova.
And Misery doesn't get to play Lion.
Yes. That is a nice silver lining.
Really nice
well.
Side benefit. In my opinion, his best hero. That doesn't mean that he is not... Up to standards with other heroes, but his line is outstanding.
I mean, after maybe FY at Fenrir, obviously, I guess they have to get the nod since they're in the Grand Finals. I think Misery's been the most impressive support player by like quite a long shot in this tournament. Always finds his farm, has an impact performance early, too.
Yeah, he's been really good, too, in my opinion. But yeah, absolutely right. I wonder what they're going to get for Misery. So my memory of all the games of Cloud9 I've seen in this tournament have been Misery Lion or Spirit Breaker. I can't remember seeing any other hero. He might have played one, especially in the Tinker series that I didn't get to see.
He plays a bit of Ancient Apparition sometimes when they want to go for their split push. Let's just nuke you down from afar. Works well than Assassinate for finding things.
But they haven't pulled that out this tournament, right? They haven't used it
a
single time.
Not at the finals here.
We've also seen his Lina. He gets the Fasules.
Oh, yeah. Lina's good. Lina's a good pick for him as well. Might be their backup plan when he doesn't get the Lion.
Yeah, if they want to run support Phoenix, though, the Lina doesn't feel like the best.
Cloud9 banned out the Naga. I think last game really showed, and we've seen a few times how Naga is just a great carry matchup against Sniper.
And the Naga-Zeus duo just works so well together, as Purge was talking about. You just burn them down with the Radiance, and you finish them off with the Zeus.
And it's actually really interesting how, when you think about Sniper, the key word against Sniper is gap closing, right? It's getting up close and personal, and because of that, you often think about heroes that get up there close and personal fast. But it can be just as useful to get up there close and personal slowly, as long as you don't die while doing it, right? So you just Song of the Siren, you get your entire team in position for catching the Sniper, and you can just kill him off. So it's actually a really nice hero that isn't super intuitively good against Sniper, but he deals poorly with illusions. Song of the Siren has massive range. It's longer a range than Sniper's attack range, so you can just cast in the middle of a fight and surround him.
The Brood Ban, something you've been mentioning quite a few times, Gods, is a pocket pick for Luo.
Just got to cover your bases sometimes. Cloud9 I lost a game yesterday to the Ice Brood. They've lost games to the Secret Zai Brood.
Isn't a good Axe game here for Luo? I think that's the big Luo here on the pool. Goes pretty well against the Chen Army. Good initiator for the Zeus Lion.
He matches up really poorly against Sniper, though.
That is true. But, I mean, who else is there at this point? They got to get someone.
Oh, he's better this game than the previous.
There's no Lion this time. They have a Chen, so not really the best hero to stop that charge.
And this time they have super good follow-up. They have Zuzalt, they have Finger.
They actually have damage. Last game they had
just killing the target.
Only damage output was coming from the Sniper. Anytime Lycan tried to run in, because he went for a Necro 3 first, as you kind of, I think he should have, but he would just die to the Zeus.
And they also have better intel now. They've got the Zeus ult to scout as well, so he knows if it's safe to charge.
I think Spirit Break is still a decent pick here. Yeah, like Syndrome just said.
I think they're considering it, but I don't think they're grabbing it yet, which could actually give it to Misery. I don't know if he wants to play it against those heroes, though. It's kind of IG with the heroes that Cloud9 had last game against.
How about Burning? Because his hero definitely has not been picked yet. Jug is a big Burning hero. We've seen Morphling. Quite a bit of Morphling.
They're picking the AA. I think this may... if they pick Morphling third, Cloud9 can respond with the AA themselves. They could just pick the Morphling fourth, but...
I think Phantom Lancer is going to run over the Cloud9 lineup if they don't get a way of dealing with that. That would be my
they don't really
highest
have
priority pick
for
IG. It's really, really good in this game, I think. So the thing about Phantom Lance that's interesting is that when you think about Illusion heroes, you think, okay, heroes that have AoE damage and AoE lockdown are really good to just shut them down, but Doppelganger doesn't really care about it. So if you get hit by Fire Spirits, you just Doppelganger and you keep chasing down. He completely just runs over Sniper. You charge in on him, you use Doppelganger, and he dies, and he doesn't really have an escape. Natural Diffusal carry against the Mask of Madness, you lock him down and take him out.
There are Fire Spirits has four of them, though. You Doppelganger out of one, he's got three more, depending on when you use it.
It's true, if the Phoenix is on point and plays it very well, but it's very situational that you will be able to hit multiple Fire Spirits on the same hero in that kind of scenario.
You know who else I like? I mentioned it yesterday, we did not see it. I like Void again this game. I saw that Burning's played. I think Lil could take the offlane, and it goes so well with the Ancient Apparition Zeus. You're guaranteed to get off, two Chain Lightnings, the Zeus ult, probably a Thunderbolt during a Chrono, and you've got the Icy Vortex to buff them all up.
PL's even better damage now.
Could be a choice.
He runs over Refraction instantly.
Yeah, this will be a big pick for IG.
So Zeus is going mid now. We've got the Lion AA. Don't think we see an offlane Zeus at all. We're looking for a Lua here and a Burning Hero. Spirit Breaker seems very viable with nothing to cancel the charge yet.
Good lockdown for potential BKB carries as well.
Only annoying thing is going to be the Phoenix Fire Spirits. It's really good against Chen drafts, I feel, as well, because that means you're up against a dual lane in that off lane. Sniper is a bit annoying to lane against. But
can IG get away with a Spectre, do you guys think? Or is that too greedy here?
They could, but I don't think they need to.
Yeah, I think they
could. And I actually don't even think it's better than PL in this game.
Yeah, so you really like the PL still. Yeah.
I like PL. Morphling, I think, is also good. But
oh, this we did not expect. This is... It's normally the 430 hero, the Ember. Is this an offlane Zeus, 430 Ember?
Do they change the lanes off of this? Yeah.
I think it's a 430 Ember and then offlane Luo Zeus, maybe? I don't think Bernie will play the Zeus.
You can burn down Refraction, but Ember Spirit with his terrible armor is not incredible against TA.
No, definitely not.
I don't know. How does that 1v1 go?
I think Flame. Oh, you just mean the 1-on-1?
Yeah, like if it's TA versus Ember. I don't feel like Ember actually wins that.
I think TA wins. Or she wins by a bit, at least. And then with Chen's help, it's super easy.
Comes down to execution, though, because you can meld dodge the chains. Sometimes we see TAs take more points in meld early and not bother leveling up Refraction in that matchup.
I remember reading a funny stat about Ember Spirit after, I don't know how it's gone since then, but there was a stat that after the 4th of April, he went 1-17 in competitive Dota.
Yeah, wow.
He has one of the worst win rates. So he must have the worst win rate over the last month.
Is there any chance of an IG tri lane here, do you think, offensively with the AA?
Could they...
I don't know if you... Do you put the Ember there?
You could do... Zeus against the Phoenix in the Ember mid?
So you're thinking safe lane Zeus and then aggro try? Yeah.
I don't think I'm just...
If they wanted to go maybe a troll, I guess that could work.
I think it's very important that the Ember gets a solo lane. Was that one of your suggestions to try lane him?
Try lane the third pick.
Ember can destroy this game with fast levels. They have zero silences, zero stuns, and the sniper headshot can be annoying, but you can still play around with your spirits because it doesn't stun.
Aggro try lane, troll is really still good. In the pool. That's always something to keep in mind. Could we see... Finally, maybe a troll.
All right, so they try to get a solution here for Ember mainly with this disruptor pick.
They
pretty good against him.
Needed just a safe lane support too for the sniper.
So it will be a bone 7 Phoenix. What do IG want to
Does
round
Burning
this
play Ember?
I've never seen him play Ember. I'm sure he can, but
I was thinking Magnus is a possibility, but I don't even know if they would be interested in that. Like, they would have really good Wombo combo, and Power is great on Ember Spirit, but I don't think it's necessary for him to.
They don't have a whole lot of time here. IG down to about 10 seconds, and it is the PL synth. Yeah.
It's such a good
An annoying sniper lineup for IG. They can chuck in a lance, the Zeus bolts you, you get hit by an ice blast, Ember sliding through. Like, they don't even really have to commit to do tons of damage. This is a cool draft from IG.
I think, okay, so in the last game, both Gods and I thought IG were going to win based on the draft, and we were really wrong.
Are you going to do it again?
I feel way more confident this time. Yeah. I think IG's draft kicks ass against this Radiant
I think as they take the Beastmaster Zeus out of Fata's hands, they still have the Phoenix, but it feels like IG's draft is looking much more solid this time around. I don't feel like Cloud9 have a weak draft by any means, but I'm feeling much more confident about IG this game.
All right. Well, perhaps a lot of it will come down to this Misery Disruptor. Looks like they're big playmaking support here. Only so much the Chen can really do against an Ember and a PL. And it will be the offlane Zeus in the end for Luo, it looks like. Unless they go aggressive tri-lane, but we'll see soon enough. So, assuming that IG wins this, if they do, we would go to a Game 3, but Cloud9 are going to look to close them out. And with that, we'll go ahead and hand it off to our commentators here. Zayori Purge, take it away.
All right, game number 2 of Cloud9 versus IG, your lower bracket finals. This is what it all comes down to, Purge. Cloud9, one win away from finding themselves in the grand finals to face off against Vici Gaming.
It's going to be a tough one for them. They have very, very few disables. I feel like if Ember Spirit does get ahead here, he can do anything he wants to end the game out. I mean, Disruptor in some ways is a good counter against him, but if he jumps far away with his ultimate, you can't glimpse. So I feel like if he plays it correctly, it's going to be a stomp here. So I'm pretty worried for C9. They're smoking uphill, and they're going to spot him, actually.
Oh, good positioning from Fata. He reveals the smoke. Shrapnel rains down to give C9 plenty of intel. Hex comes out onto Envy. Fata in the front lines with the refraction on, trying to focus down Chuan, but it's Fata that goes down first. First blood goes the way of the Lion. They'll lose the Chen as well. A 1-for-2 to get things started, favoring Invictus Gaming. Misery should be able to make it away. He does have boots, giving him a little bit of an edge here. The first smoke from IG proving successful, finding a successful exchange and a first blood.
That is just the power of Chilling Touch right there. He caught his whole team with it. That gives you extra sources of damage. And once they did actually focus on the TA,
this is going to be a Misery sandwich. Chuan comes in, starts off with a Hex. There is your Spirit Lance from the backside.
He's got boots, though. He'll be okay.
Yeah,
pretty scary, though.
Pretty good. He'll make him chew through a few of those tangos.
So not only do they get some kills here, but they're also destroying the jungle with wards. Very low chance that No-Tail can do anything in his jungle. He's going to almost immediately have to go to the enemy jungle, and that's actually what he's doing. He said, okay, they're invading our jungle. They're obviously going to ward everything. I'm going to have to jungle on their side of the map. So he's going to be vulnerable to the A and the line, unless they aggressively try lane, in which case it's going to be okay.
Yeah, and let's see how these lanes will set up. Looks like Misery will be bottom with Fata on the TA, so switching things up a bit there. It is Envy going mid on the sniper, and that puts Bone 7 in the off lane on the Phoenix. This is very rare for Cloud9. They almost exclusively run the sniper in the safe lane.
It makes
complete
sense, because Sniper is really good against Ember Spirit. He's got very low armor. Sniper does a lot of physical damage. When you're trying to last hit with Ember Spirit, if you do get headshot, it reduces your attack speed, which means you can't last hit. So I was thinking they might do this lane setup during the draft, because Sniper is actually so good versus Ember. Probably one of the reasons that Ember's win rate is so bad right now. So he should have a big win rate here, or a good chance of getting more CS. I actually really like the lanes that C9 has. Fata's going to get gimped on the bot lane, but you've got a Phoenix versus a Zeus solo, which is dangerous for Zeus, and you have an aggressively jungling Chen. So if Chen gets a good disable and he gets behind the Zeus, that's a dead hero every time. So I feel like they can win mid and the top lane. Bot's going to not go so well, but I think this is a C9 lane advantage.
I would agree, and I think for Cloud9, the key factor will be making sure Fata doesn't get killed too often. Sure, he won't farm that well, but if IG don't kill him, I think this aggro try is just not quite worth it. Burning will get decent farm to get things started. 7-6, denying quite heavy, and they'll even start rotating supports around to leave Fata all by his lonesome, realizing that Misery's presence down here doesn't really do too much. Luo gets hit by a shockwave. Bone 7, he may find a kill here with the help of Big Daddy, and they will. Zeus sent to the grave.
And possibly even a gank mid. They're going to be going for the kill. Ferrari wants it. All depends on headshot procs and where those stuns land.
He's here got the searing chains, field. But they don't connect. Now the kinetic field comes out. That buys Envy some time. Chuan's here.
He's slow. He's got boots. Oh, there's a haste. Oh my gosh.
Wow.
I think he might have been dead otherwise.
Yeah. Chuan has boots and Envy doesn't. That definitely would have been a kill. Now Misery in pretty deep in the enemy jungle, but Chen is nearby. IG, privy to this, will not look to move into their own jungle.
Could see a dive mid as well. I wouldn't be too unexpected. He's got poor man's shield though, so he's fairly tanky, but still very low armor, and this should mean that Sniper gets a lot of farm. The only thing I'm a little worried about for C9 here is how much experience and last hits Fada is going to get here. It's going to be a tough game for him. There is some rotations from Chuan, obviously, so his lane is going to go a bit better now, but he's actually doing the old school hide in your lane with the meld.
Yeah.
It's working out okay.
Well, he is halfway through level 3. Not too shabby, given that he's been at a disadvantage in terms of a 1v2
or
2v3. Bernie may actually fall here. About 20 HP remaining. Fada will get hit by Cold Feet, but wow, if he found a kill there,
that would have been the most
disastrous for IG.
Oh my gosh. That was really surprising. So, a little bit of dewarding in the jungle here, but very wisely, IG double blocked the pull camp. So, very unlikely they'll find the other one. But at least, no, actually, they blocked the heck out of the jungle.
Uh-oh,
they might get
Faith now in some trouble. Kinetic Field comes out. Spirit Glance onto Fada. They actually have the damage to finish off Faith here. No, not quite. Ancient Apparition will live.
He felt tanky there. That was weird. I've never seen an AA look tanky before.
Now in the mid lane, Envy is in a lot of trouble. 430 going in deep. Chuan with the disables. Will they actually find the kill, though? They do. Can Bone7 punish this? Chuan goes down first.
Wow.
The Ember Spirit goes down second. A 1-for-2 and another great trade for Cloud9.
Man, C9's TP supports have been so good this series so far. Every time somebody gets dived, somebody else is ready. And it's not always just supports, it's even cores as well. And that's going to accelerate him pretty well, much more than he was going to get from lane. He's level 6, he can turn this into a gank somewhere on the map. Maybe bot lane, for example. If he shows up bot lane and they have another kind of a slow, I mean, he can definitely get a double kill.
It looks like No-Tail been pretty successful with his aggressive jungling. Already finding level 4. It looks like the courier will ferry out a couple items for him. Get those boots going, another round of sentries. And now Lua will get wrapped around on. He's got two good creeps here. Shockwave will get things started. There's a thunderclap ready to rock and roll. Luo has a TP, and he should be able to make it out. Big Daddy does have that first penance, and it just doesn't give him enough damage. Still forces the Zeus back, so a victory there. Oh, down bottom, all the while. Templar Assassin goes down, but the Disruptor punishes the Ember Spirit. 1-for-1, both cores falling.
I feel like that's kind of okay. I mean, Templar Assassin's levels are still pretty good here since he's been solo, and that gives a level to Misery, who's been a little underleveled. So level 3 for him, he gets a DD. I think that's okay in the scope of the game here. Ember's the scary hero, right? That's what we talked about.
Oh, up top, Bone7. Icarus dive onto Chuan, gets hexed straight away, but now Chuan's still in a lot of trouble. Chen creeps are nearby. It's a freebie on the Demon Witch. Bone7 gets another.
C9 is just ganking all around the map, and it's always, in most cases, IG defensively, so things are going really well for them. Maybe another kill on Burning they're going to try. Misery doesn't have a glimpse, though. It's a little tough.
There's the Doppelgang. Fata will be okay. Burning could be in some trouble here. Thunderstrikes come out. Fata getting very aggressive. Meld Strike, not enough to bring him down as 430 does rotate. Glimpse back.
Great.
That'll push 430 back.
He jumps
connects
back
with
again.
The chains, though. Maybe Burning. Can he reinitiate here?
Doesn't have the mana.
Nope. Icarus Dive flying through. Bone7 does have a Supernova available, but won't use it. And looks like we could potentially have a pause here at the behest of the admin.
Our screen on the main stage is not working right now, unfortunately. That's why I heard boos. I was like, what is going on?
Yeah, Mita, I was wondering why they were booing. Good call, Purge.
Really well played there by Ferrari. He sent a second Remnant out as soon as the Glimpse acted. That way he could jump back in. But at early levels, you don't have that much mana. It costs 150 to activate your Fire Remnant. It's very expensive, so low chance that he was going to be able to reinitiate. He tried to bottle through it, but very high-skilled play from him, but he just didn't have the resources to do it.
That's like almost half your mana pool.
Yeah. That's a lot early on. That's why you usually see drums picked up on Ember Spirit, because you just need a bit more mana to be useful there.
Yeah.
So, good gank attempt, but didn't work out. Good reaction from Misery.
So, looking at the more macroscopic perspective of this game, Cloud9 holding on to nearly a four-figure net worth lead and a very big experience edge. A lot of that coming out of the Chen, spending time in the jungle, but ahead by about 2K. Very nice start for them. Envy took a spill early, but still farming very nicely. Finds a timely level 6, 1-1 and 2, and actually the last hit leader. IG starting to fall behind in raw CS.
Yeah, they're definitely doing very well. I really like the way the Big Daddy's been ganking so far. Got kills mid, got kills top, made them shift lanes a lot. They forced Lion to shift off the lane, which meant that Fada gets more levels and experience. He's got 10 CS, 2 deaths, but he does have 2 assists, which is pretty good. He's definitely going to be a...
There we go.
We got the screen, guys.
We got our video feedback. Looks like that few minutes may turn into a few seconds here.
So we can return in a second. Ancient Apparition actually level 4. He's leveling pretty well this game. See what he prioritizes for levels. I feel like a more active Abe build might be good this game since he's aggressive. Normally we just see maxing out Ice Vortex as fast as possible. It's still really good this game for Ice Vortex. There's a Zeus. You've got an Ember Spirit, which is almost all magic damage in the early game. You've got a Lion. You have a PL. It's pretty magic heavy, at least with lances and stuff. So I feel like he has to max Ice Vortex this game. It's so good.
Okay, so here we go. Just a short pause, and we'll get right back into this game. 6-4 in the first 6 minutes of gameplay. It's been pretty active so far, and it's Cloud9 that have found the edge. Luo right back to farming in the top lane. Xuan only level 3 right now, not making really quick progress towards that Finger of Death, and that is a timing that IG look for to find some kills. Ooh, bottom rune. Ferrari will get pushed back as Bone7 grabs a bounty.
That's a really big rune to steal from him. He was a bit low on HP, and now he has to say, I can last it a little bit, but I'm going to just TP home. That's the only thing he can really do here. So teleports home. He'll have to use a remnant there to come back to base, and it looks like they denied the regen rune on the top lane as well. So no runes for him. A little bit less efficient.
Mm-hmm. Cost 100 gold. In the mid lane, trying to just leech to his level 6 and be making that difficult, spamming out that assassinate. Smart heads-up play against the Ancient Apparition, who is rather weak at these early levels. Though Dust already in the inventory of Faith, he is ready to pick on this TA a little bit if Fada overcommits or he finds an opportunity.
The pull camp is finally unblocked though, so Disruptor can grab some levels here. Probably going to stack first because he doesn't want to push the lane. No, he's actually just going to single pull here. He doesn't have a Tango, so I'm not really sure what he's going to do about the push afterwards. Maybe they're actually just going to go for a push. They actually do have a catapult here, so if you only single pull, it's just going to stack the wave and then it'll push afterwards. So maybe they'll try to take a tower with this, but I feel like it's a little hard for them to do this unless they get a major rotation. Maybe Bone7 coming down, since he does have a level advantage, he can supernova under the tower and give them a really good tower potential.
Yeah, Bone7's been farming very well this game. Actually, second on net worth. Pulling up gold, probably will just go for that Hand of Midas, the tried and true classic on the offlane Phoenix, and make that progress towards the prize level 16 to max out the egg.
And No Tail City behind him top. He's got his ultimate up. That's going to do a lot at 7 minutes in. That's actually their most leveled heroes. Sniper's doing really well, No Tail's doing really well, and Phoenix is doing really well. So we'll see most of the impact come from those guys.
Mm-hmm. Luo now rotating towards the mid lane. He's at least level 6, has that Thunder God's Wrath, as well as a Soul Ring, so it can contribute from around the map. Down bottom, Fata may get initiated on here. Ferrari starting it off, chains on 2. The smoke rotation will yield a kill on the Disruptor, but can they get Fata? Supernova in a beautiful position, 430, getting low. He'll fall, Fata stays alive. The egg gets completed. And it's a 1-for-2 buyback onto Misery, hoping to find another consolation kill, but they can't.
That's maybe not over yet. He might get a glimpse off here if Chuan sidesteps, but...
And in the top lane, Big Daddy manages to push a tier 1 tower. Cloud9 finding victories all across the map.
Might be a dead Zeus. It's going to be tough to chase him down. He does have one more shrapnel, but he has tranquil boots and a lot of HP. There's no way he'll die to this.
He will push him back to the well, but not enough for the kill.
Yeah. So they did buy back on Misery, which was a waste, but if they did catch a glimpse, that would have an extra kill. It's very inexpensive to buy back in the early game, 250 gold. As a support who has 3 kills and he's level 5 at 8 minutes, it's not that big of a deal. It's going to hurt his Tranquil Boots, but Disruptor is a hero.
Oh, dang. Plenty of damage to bring down the Sniper. Envy tried to TP home after the chains came out, but the Thunder God's Wrath was there, and Luo helps to secure the kill for Ferrari.
Yeah, so it's totally fine that Disruptor is underleveled and or underfarmed slightly. The hero doesn't need that much to be useful. Really just a Tranquils and an Urn, and you're pretty happy on this hero. So totally fine to chance for an extra kill with a buyback.
Yeah, the XP almost more important. He's very close to level 6, yeah. So if that buyback did yield a kill because of the glimpse,
totally
he finds
true.
Level 6, absolutely worth it. Even though it didn't work out, I think the right idea there for sure. So Burning, how's his item progression going here? He's sitting on Brown Boots, Aquila. What is the go-to build for PL? Do you think just straight into Diffusal is what Burning should be looking for here?
I think if you're fighting a lot early, a drum kind of makes sense. But it is about half the cost of a Diffusal Blade, so there's arguments to be made that you should just finish Diffusal as fast as possible. But if we look at nuke damage, I feel like C9s is fairly high, so it might be worth to grab a drum first. But the earlier you get the Diffusal, the earlier you do ridiculous amounts of damage, because your illusions do very low percentages of damage compared to the previous PL since his recent change. They only do, what, 16%? They used to do a bit higher than that. So Diffusal Blade really amplifies your illusion damage more than it did in the past. So it kind of just depends what he wants to do this game.
Yeah, I would agree. So 430, making a rotation for that 10-minute rune. Looking to fill up his bottle here.
Ooh.
And it looks like he'll be able to do that. Grabs himself a bounty rune and then just back down towards the bottom lane to go to farming. Cloud9 with a sneaky play to smoke into Roche, and it looks like it will yield an Aegis here at the 10-minute mark. Nice heads-up play, and it works out. Aegis of the Immortal goes to Fata. Now Chuan initiated on, brought down in a matter of seconds. C9 not only getting a big map objective, but a freebie kill on top of it.
And Fata's skill build here really helped that out. He maxed out Melt first because it gives him a lot of burst damage, and because he didn't have a lot of mana regen from the mid lane like you normally expect, he just went for all these melt levels because it's fairly low mana cost. It keeps him survivable. It's burst damage. It's something you need more in the laning stage, like in a safe lane, rather than in mid. Mid is more of a farming oriented in most cases. Is Farah going to die to creeps?
I was asking myself the same question. Luckily, he had a Revenant down behind the tower, but Big Daddy putting a lot of pressure on the Ember Spirit. He'll have to chew through some of those bottle charges to go back to farming.
That's a good set of four creeps. They all have a nuke. Look at that. Two Shurikens. It does like 250 magic damage. That's amazing. Another two claps could do another 150 each. If he didn't have his ultimate there, he definitely would have died.
And just eats right through that flame guard. Big Daddy putting decent pressure on this tower, though, will recall his army, make sure they don't get picked off. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Cloud9 all grouped up, and that's where that Shen army's headed. They want to pressure this tier 1 tower mid. IG do have a glyph, and they could mount a defense here if they want to take a fight. But mech up on Big Daddy. Fata with an Aegis as well as a double damager, and this might not be a fight you want to take. Lua will get softened up with the assassinate, and IG forced to just watch their tier 1 fall in the mid lane as Cloud9 apply the pressure.
TA's recovered really well here. He's level 8 now. He can continue pushing. And even with just Treads Aquila here, he's a huge threat towards enemy heroes. Chasing down Zeus. He's in trouble. Oh, Melt.
Oh, glimpse back. Now Zeus in a lot of trouble. He'll certainly go down. Bone 7, maybe a little too aggressive. Has the Supernova. Supernova. Gets it off. Compliments of the mech. Burning, committing deep for it. They will kill the Phoenix, but will Burning get punished? It looks like that is a resounding yes here, Purge. He'll get brought down. The double damage on Fata helping it out, but it's Misery that gets credit for the kill. A 1-for-2 as C9 dive the tier 2 tower in the mid lane. Ferrari doing everything he can to repel them, but forced to hop back to his remnant in the base. Tier 2 tower mid now under assault at about half damage. Another glyph for IG is available, but I'm not sure they can hold this tower, Purge.
The Chen plus Sniper combo, if you have a gold advantage, is just so strong, and Fata as well in the Templar Assassin gives you some nice burst damage. Ferrari being slowed.
Ferrari forced to jump back to the base. A lot of TPs coming in from IG. Fata with a couple seconds left on the double damage rune, enough to almost get Luo low. Double digits of HP, but he will survive. Chuan with a stun onto Fata. I like the way Fata's playing this. With the Aegis, he can just be so aggressive here, zoning out all of Invictus Gaming, opening up to pressure this tower. The tier 2 tower will go down, and IG just can't stop it.
Zeus ulti not really doing that much. Dive back in. Chuan's low. They're chasing him down, looking for a melt strike. Doesn't even need it. Chuan falls.
Easy kill for the sniper.
Even with two levels of refraction here, it's still blocking four instances of damage, and a lot of IGs isn't damage over time. Like a Zeus Bolt obviously will proc a static field as well, which is two charges, but if you eat an Earth Spike or even a Spirit Lance, it's blocking a huge amount of damage for the early game. And then even if things get dangerous, you've got Chen ult and you have a mechanism from him. So their pushing lineup is just so strong right now. This just might be a fast 2-0.
A little bit of Kale coming out on the field here. Hopefully just a server hiccup. Looks like we'll have a quick resume. But yeah, 430's Flame Guard is their main way to chew through the refraction, but he's just so squishy, he can't really stay committed to these fights long enough to chew through the refraction at the rate you would expect. He will go for Drum of Endurance, so that'll help beef him up just a little bit. But all things considered, this Ember Spirit not getting the momentum that IG were hoping for. Cloud9 will continue to just push towers down. The last remaining tier 1 for IG will get taken out by the Chen army.
No last hit there, which is a bit of a mistake. It's about 250 gold loss, but they have a good advantage. Glimpse back for Ferrari. Here comes. He's going to flame. Oh, he actually...
Oh, okay, beautifully done by Ferrari. Not the easiest thing to time, but he will make it back.
Yeah, nicely done by him. So they're doing a good job just nuking him down. Again, they don't have very many disables, so if he does... If they don't have enough damage, he can just run with the entire game. But luckily, they've been hitting him hard enough with Meld Strikes, reducing his armor, so that everybody's right clicks have been good, since they do have a lot of ranged heroes. But the important part is that if you look at Bone7's items, he's just building Sheepstick first.
Wow.
And this is really smart considering that they have no stuns. If they get a Hex, they can jump on Ember Spirit and blow him up in 3.5 seconds very easily. And that's what they need to close out this game, even if the Ember Spirit does get a big burst of advantage in the mid game. So I really like the itemization here. He doesn't have to worry about dying except for a 2-line. But they're so far ahead, and they have a chance, so he's pretty survivable.
Gonna Faith, see Faith in the wrong place at the wrong time here. Do they actually have the damage to bring him down? No, but it's a close call.
You have to cast that almost immediately. Brings me back to your beast, does it not?
Yeah.
Snipers canceling TPs. It's the only way.
Things looking very good for Cloud9, though, holding about a 7,000 net worth lead, experience at about 4K, nice advantage for 15 minutes into the game. Their Aegis of the Immortal just about to expire here in a couple seconds. They got great use out of it, though, as Fata, soon to be level 11, will just take over the mid lane for now to find a little extra farm.
Doing
a lot of damage to Ferrari, but who's actually afraid of who here? It's Fata on the back foot. Ice Blast flying in. It will connect. That's the end of the Aegis, just seconds before it would expire. Wow.
That hero kills TA so fast.
A little bit of luck there for Fata, though. I mean, literally 2 seconds before that Aegis was gone.
Oh, wow, was that close?
Yeah, it was very, very close. Now Glimpse back onto Faith. Kinetic Field, Static Storm, Misery. Almost looking for a solo kill here. Icarus Dive will help him out. And Faith heads back to the well.
And Misery's playing amazing. 6-1-0 on a support hero.
Now down bottom. Envy squaring up with Ferrari 430. But the all heal from Chen keeps Envy alive. And 430 will make it back, but very low on HP.
Man, Ferrari's such a good player, man. Look how much space he's creating despite his team being insanely behind. He doesn't even have that many items, but he's going for these kills. He's forcing space and doing a lot of stuff. So for the rest, for now, IG Burning is just going to go farm into the jungle. He did go for a drum here, as did Ferrari.
Yeah, it looks like Misery will just go straight for the Aghanim Scepter. He has a point booster already in tow. Actually, really good farm on this Disruptor. He's at about 3,400 net worth compared to Chuan's Lion at only 2K. And Chuan will pick up a Magic Wand and a whole medley of items here. Looks like he'll get his Arcane Boots secured, but no Fast Blink Dagger on this Demon Witch.
He has died so many times.
Yeah,
always tries to help out people, but doesn't work out. Burning, that's an Invis, actually.
Burning in some trouble here, more than a little. Meldstrike will connect. Burning with no support nearby. There is a tier 2 tower that someone could TP to.
He's so
one
tanky
on the way, and yeah, he'll survive.
People
not getting
actually,
that space to farm.
He has so much armor. 3 armor or 3 agility per level and really high base armor. He's actually one of the best melee heroes against an axe in most cases because his
armor
is so
high. He's now picked
up
the drums also, so getting a little extra meat on his bones.
Yeah.
Very tanky indeed. Bone 7 closing in on that Sheepstick, though. About 1K gold away. Looking to be a very good timing, somewhere around that 20-minute mark or so.
That's a great timing. It's going to help a lot. He can definitely solo kill here if he catches him with the dive. And he does forces a TP.
They both TP. Okay.
See you, man.
All right. Meanwhile, in the top lane, though, Cloud9 all grouped up, continuing to pressure towers. Uh-oh, in the jungle. Misery caught by an Impale and a Finger. Zeus will finish him off, and that'll end the dominating streak on Misery.
And a ward.
It's a little scary. Do they actually want to fight this, or are they going to retreat?
They got to get out there in
trouble
now.
Looks like it'll be the ladder, but Big Daddy caught by the Searing Chains. He'll go down first. Fata left behind as well. Ice Blast will connect. Refraction buys him a little bit of time. Almost finds the kill on Ferrari, but can't get it. It's a 3-0, and IG finally find a good exchange.
That's going to be a big gold advantage for IG since they are behind.
Yeah.
That, like a 2K gold swing just from those 3 kills. But it was a great catch there. Misery got a little too close. He was like, oh, I think I can kill this line. But the stun set him up. Zeus got in the area. We won't see Zeus die here unless we see a Fire Spirit land. It does. It's going to be close. Last
will
tick.
Will be enough damage? Purge it is. Just barely. Bone 7 gets another one on the scoreboard. Envy going for a slightly different build. Casual Morbid Mask into the Sun. Skipping the Mask of Madness for now and just trying to get some extra HP so that he can survive a bit longer.
Yeah, this is a really scary game to go Mask of Madness. Not only is there Zeus ult, but if Ember Spirit gets on top of you, you're just going to die. The hero does tons of magic damage in a very close proximity, and that's not something that he can allow it to enhance with the Mask of Madness bonus damage. JK, okay, he got
He gets the Mask of Madness right away, so... But he still delayed it. I think the point is the same, that rushing the Mask of Madness here would have been an unnecessary risk, I think, fair to say.
He's got to be careful, though. He has to stay far away from the Ember Spirit, maybe let the Ember go on other allies of his, and then he can initiate.
And the success of that fight for IG does push Burning at number one on net worth.
That's actually amazing.
About 2,500 gold, so if he wants that Diffusal Blade next, he's closing in.
And once he gets that, it gets really scary for the TA as well, because then you've got multiple damage sources. It's a tough, really tough Templar Assassin game. And maybe that's why Fata's just not maxing out his Refraction skill, because he's not expecting to get much value out of it. Mm-hmm. He's like, I'm going to get Psyblades, because I'm just expecting to try to sit back as much as possible. But
I think it's the right approach. He picks up the Yasha now, so still transitioning into what could be a scary late game TA, but will take him a little while longer.
it's still looking not amazing. I'm a little worried for him, honestly. There's just so many. Maybe he just needs to get a BKB, honestly. Because if he gets BKB with Yasha, he doesn't have to worry about all his DOT sources. They're just not going to work on him because it's all magic damage. So yeah, I think true. He has to get a fast BKB here because everything just counters him too bad. AA, Diffusal Blade is going to break him too fast, and he definitely needs mana, so getting his mana drained as well would just be terrible for him.
Well, that gold lead that Cloud9 had now stagnating a little bit as they look for more options around the map to perhaps find pickoffs. Next Roshan should be coming up pretty soon. Of course, Cloud9 do have that intel advantage with the side traps, one thing that TA does offer, not just the minus armor, but the scouting potential inside of the Rosh pit. Look at this, Bone7, he picks up his Scythe of Vice. 20 minutes on the dot. Great news for Cloud9. Chuan, he's going to get sandwiched
Hex
here.
Hex is up.
Easy kill. Can they find another? Burning on the run. Already used his escape tool. Now caught by the laser. Nowhere to go. No TPs to save him. It's a 2-0 for Cloud9. Great smoke rotation across the map to debut that Scythe. And it does catch IG a little bit unaware. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Ferrari trying to cut the lane. There will be a TP back from Envy, but of course, there is a Fire Remnant down deep
Misery
in the dire jungle, and he'll be okay.
Misery Bottom finds though.
Fata against Luo and Faith. Action happening all over the map here. Luo will try to TP home. Fata doesn't quite have the damage, but does push Luo back to the base.
So the Hex is finished for Phoenix. He's going to get a lot of Hexes. I look at this kind of like a Midas. You think about every Hex that you get in the team fight for the rest of the game. It's like having half of an extra hero. It's like you have a free line on your team.
Yeah.
Maybe Faith dying. Oh, there's the glimpse back. And the ultimate, very likely he's going to die. Been a tough game for Faith.
And on the other side of it, Envy taking some damage from 430, but he does repel the Ember Spirit. Kind of two fights breaking out there at once.
Ooh, gets slowed. Actually gets caught. He's in a lot of trouble. That's Finger of Death. Easy kill.
There you go.
That was really patient sleight of fisting, too, because that was jumping through creeps. He waited until the moment when I was closer to Sniper and was able to land the latch. That's a big kill. Ferrari is just making so much space out of nothing this game.
Yeah, and he was falling a little bit behind in terms of net worth, but now only 500 behind that of the Sniper. IG stopping Cloud9 from getting that snowball rolling even bigger. They still have two outer towers to knock down, and they're not going to go down without a fight. Zeus gets picked off in the bottom lane with a combination of Fata and Misery.
Yeah, again, Misery's been playing great. 6-2-2 here, catching people out of position. He's been moving everywhere, just looking for glimpse setups. I don't think IG can really know what to expect. You know, Disruptor's been bottom, mid, jungle, top lane. Their wards are really aggressive as well. It's opening them up a lot of opportunities. It's kind of like, I feel like Ferrari's being the space creator on IG, and Misery's doing the same for C9 here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Well, Roshan number two has respawned. Cloud9 have already scouted it out, and we'll see when they opt to move into the pit. They ping out this ward, Sentry comes down straight away, and they will get vision control in this area. IG should be pretty suspicious, but you look at their vision around the map, and there's not a hell of a lot.
So we've got Ferrari going for a Battle Fury, which is a good item, especially against Chen. He's going to be able to cleave off of all of those sources. Things get a little scary there for C9, but one dive comes forward. No Hex. Hex was used, actually. Grabbed an illusion. Wrong one.
That's unfortunate.
That's a dead illusion. They got that going for
Envy just farming in the top lane. Still haven't seen much item progression since that Mask of Madness. I reckon SNY will just be coming out next. And we'll see where he wants to go from there.
May see a team fight here.
Yep, rotation's coming all about. Envy still just off by his lonesome. He does have a couple of TP scrolls. There's your ultimate from Zeus. IG reveal their smoke at the Rosh pit. Bone7 taking a lot of damage. Gets stunned up. He has the supernova. He gets it off and stays alive. This could be the turn for the fight, though. Fata going in deep. Gets finished off first. Envy isolated off to the side by the Ember Spirit. Great plays from Ferrari, but now hexed up. Maybe they can turn on him. Zeus will be the next to fall. Ferrari stays alive. Oh, ends up going down. Pardon me. Buyback, though. He wants to get back in this fight. They get the kill on to Misery. The fight kind of going in all sorts of different directions here. Big Daddy will TP out, and it looks like IG will actually take this one. Even though the buyback was used, they still find a net worth gain, and of course they repel the Roche, which is the big thing.
Yeah, I think that was a great fight for IG, definitely. They killed Sniper as well. TA died. Wasn't that much he could do. I still really feel like he needs BKB here, but he opts for a Manta instead. It's not terrible either. Movement speed, you can get out of some disables, dodge some spells.
Burning starting to get quite large here, Purge. 2,500 gold now, and he does have that Diffusal Blade completed. Soon to be level 16 also, as IG take their first tower of the game here at the 24-minute mark. The Tier 1 in the bottom lane turn to rubble.
The main reason that teamfight went bad, though, is because IG completely had the drop on them. If they would have had a better supernova there in the middle of the fight, we would have had tons more AoE damage, a big stun. I don't even know if he got his hex off there, at least not before the supernova. So that was just a bit unfortunate.
Burning, I think.
Okay. If he would have grabbed a better supernova, maybe landed fire spirits first, I think they could have won that fight, but it was a little too hectic. The fact that they were able to even get that many kills was really impressive for C9, based on their initial reaction, at least.
Yeah, it was a very chaotic fight, and Envy could have had a good initiation into that fight if IG didn't know where he was, but Ferrari isolated him right away and really stopped that sniper from doing damage on the back lines. Again, very, very well played, making space for the rest of his team. The recurring theme in this match, it seems, for IG.
Well, it looks like they haven't given up on that one yet. Going to spot burning. They're actually going to go for this. They actually hex him up. Bit of magic damage. Need a couple more hits. He's going to be able to doppelgain in a sec.
And he'll survive for now. And the egg comes out. They'll get the kill on the lion.
Back.
They'll try to focus down the Phoenix egg with an illusion. That's not happening. And Bone 7 will survive easily. Just a 1-0. But maybe the advantage that Cloud9 needed to go into the Roche pit. In comes the Ember Spirit. Searing Chains connect onto Bone 7 and one of the Chen creeps. Ferrari does have a double damage at rune on here, making this a little more scary.
I think they can still fight this. They've got Glimpse ulti. If they can stun him, he's jumping away. Takes a ton of damage. Glimpse. Is it too far?
I think he's too far. They're going to focus on the other side of the fight. Icarus dive almost catches Faith, but he'll be all right. Burning.
Glimpse Faith.
Uses the doppelganger. There's your Glimpse back. He'll get caught in the kinetic field. And
they'll
it's
take
a kill
that.
On Burning.
That's a hero they're happy to grab. AI Splash comes in. Heal on Chen. Well played there by Big Daddy, noticing the animation. Keeps his team alive.
Chuan is now respawned. He does have a finger. They'll send Envy back to the well. And C9 will just retreat from the mid lane. Tier 2 tower has already fallen, so not much to be gained there. They really want this Roshan. That's all they've been angling for, and IG are making it very difficult.
I like that they went for kills, though, rather than trying to sneak the Roshan instead. Their opponents don't necessarily expect it. They were able to work out a kill. Even if it was tough, they got Chuan there, and then they picked up Burning. That's completely worth it for a smoke, in my opinion. And instead, it looks like they're just going to pressure the tower. It's like, well, we don't need Roche necessarily. We're doing fine with the way we are. They don't have Chen ult, though.
This is a good place to fight for Cloud9. They've got the ward on the high ground outside of Roche, so a lot of intel if IG try to sneak around in the trees. Glyph has already been used, so this tier 2 tower will start to get pressured. Looks like IG might let this one fall. Luo gets a little too close, but Force Staff will keep him safe from the kinetic field. Bit of a close call there.
It is totally fine to try for that. The Glimpse cooldown is very low at level 4, 18 seconds, so trying for a kill every 20 is great. And that's the end of the tower. Tower goes down. Now it's even easier for them to take Roshan, because if IG decides to buy back and they don't have the nice little Ember Spirit illusion, then they're going to be able to take it.
Mm-hmm. Only one outer tower remaining for IG, the tier 2 up top. Cloud9 getting closer and closer to the IG base. Let's check in on the team net worth. It is Cloud9 holding on to their lead of about 7,500 where they were 10 minutes ago. Experience a little bit more even. I think an item that could start turning things around is that Battle Fury here for Ferrari. Getting very close.
It'll help a lot. We even saw the DD on a Sleight of Fist earlier, and it did almost nothing. I was like, oh, this is going to actually hurt. Did nothing.
Yeah.
Wasn't that bad at all. But once he grabs Battle Fury, then you start getting cleave damage, and the cleave damage is pure because it's not reduced by armor. And that's when things start getting scary. If they get a little too clumped up, it's definitely a bad situation to be in.
A lot on the back of Big Daddy to make sure those chain creeps are appropriately split so the massive cleave, first of all, doesn't kill his army and get his teammates killed.
Yeah.
Fata does pick up Manta Style as his first core item, so also getting some more meat on the bones of this Templar Assassin.
Good attack speed, too. That's another really good thing that Manta gives you. Most people underestimate. It gives you about 40% attack speed or so. It's like 26 agility and an extra 15 attack speed. It's a 41 attack speed. Good one you can damage out with refraction very rapidly. So it's a little undervalued for that aspect of it.
28-minute Handomitis here on Faith. Less than ideal in terms of timing. But still a good item to let IG try and scale towards this late game as we're approaching the 30-minute mark. And there's your Battle Fury out on Burning.
The Midas is especially good against Chen, which is why they're buying so many.
Yeah.
He said, okay, we're going to just delay this game and delay this game. We want to have a 6-slotted Ember Spirit with Rapiers, which is why his Rapier Cosmetic attached. And also Phantom Lancer in the late game is really good, as is Zeus. So they buy Midases. They'll be able to kill half of the Chen army as the fight starts. That'll significantly limit what Big Daddy's able to do in terms of auras and damage and spells. and also get them farm in the late.
Does it actually work out that way with the Midas, though? Do you want to hold that cooldown just to make sure it's ready for the Chen army? You have to find that balance of utilizing it to farm, but also having it available when the push is
going. Yeah, balance is the way to go. You don't want to only save it for the Chen creeps, but if you take a look at them, yeah, Faith just uses, he's a hero that absolutely needs the gold, but maybe Zeus can be a bit less greedy with it.
Yeah.
But it's more about predicting when the team fights are happening. It's like, oh, a fight's happening. I'll let it be off cooldown for 30 seconds until the right moment. But
yeah,
usually they want
to
farm.
And this is the go-to build for Faith. They like Ancient Apparition, and they do the Midas into Ags much more often than not. So killing two birds with one stone here in some regards.
You kind of have to do this against the Chen as well, because he's got both mech and he's ultimate, and he's very close to Aghanim Scepter, so that means he can ulti every 30 seconds. It's like a global mech every 30 seconds. So, I'm sorry, it's done. Okay.
There it is.
That's Ancient Creeps as well. That's an Ancient Granite Golem, 15% bonus HP to his team. These pushes are going to be crazy.
Fata, the one to pick up the Aegis of the Immortal off that last successful roach, is Cloud9 starting to group up towards the top. We talked about that last remaining outer tower, and it may not be remaining for too much longer. Not particularly healthy either.
So Fata, 2,900 gold. I'd like to see probably a Desolator here. I feel like it'll be really good. There's low.
Always good against Ember Spirit.
Very good against Ember Spirit. His armor is very low. If you reduce it, you're going to put it heavily negative here because Meld reduces by, what, 6 or something like that? Or 8? 8 armor reduction plus a Desolator on top. That means he's very, very low on armor. And then Sniper will probably just 4-shot him at that point.
Yeah.
Especially if he grabs a damage item himself.
Yeah, and with all that minus armor, that'll actually take PL down to the single digit. So even though he does have a lot of armor, you can still deal them that way. The tier 2 tower up top just gets melted. Envy with an S and Y and quite a bit of gold. Cloud9, they make try high ground here, Purge. No glyphs, so this play feels a little bit less risky than it otherwise would be.
Chuan,
start things off with a stun. Fata, remember, has the Aegis of the Immortal, so he will stay a little more aggressive here. Battle Fury cleaving down some creeps. Granite Golem in the front lines. There's your all heal from Chen.
Ice Blast misses, but they do still have their Granite Golem. That's the important part. Mm-hmm. They lost all their illusions and they drained all of Fata's mana, but he did have bottle charges and arcane boots, so he'll be okay here. Even arcanes on Disruptor. This is actually one of the few games where getting a lot of arcane boots is really needed, because PL's going to continue draining people, so it's important that you can mana accelerate your team.
Here we go. Next creep wave. Cloud9 move in. Bone 7 egg on top of the whole team. They can't
the
focus
damage.
Him. A beautiful supernova. They get the kill online first. Instant buyback from Chuan. Glyph has cooled down. IG could still try to make a hold here. Fata.
Great dodge from Fata.
Getting a little bit low, but he'll survive.
He manta dodged something there, that's for sure. He almost would have died. That would have been Aegis. I think they're going to back off now, because him sticking around just to say, okay, refresh my HP, that's kind of a crappy use of Aegis. You want to have full HP, force the burst, then respawn and have a second life.
And they still have a fair bit of time on the Aegis as well.
Yeah,
they can go.
They got it recently.
Yeah, regen up and then head back to the base and still make good use of it, I think. Fata getting very close to that Desolator gold, only about 400 away as we hit that 2-minute timer on the Aegis. Remember, Chuan did buy back there on the Lion. Not the most expensive of buybacks, but they didn't find any recovery kills out of it, so I think you could call it essentially wasted gold at that point.
It's actually a lot now, 760 for a buyback on a hero that wants
oh,
a 2,200 gold item. That's
right, he is higher
expensive.
Level than I thought. He is level 11 here, so.
Yeah, his level's actually hurting him a bit in that sense. Mm-hmm. His net worth is pretty low, though, again. He's been the one trying to move around the map, trying to make things happen and defend the pushes and the ganks, but C9 has had an advantage and has been making a little bit better plays. I assume we'll see a Skadi next on Sniper. It's very good against Ember Spirit, helps them deal with the PL. They have weak disables, so I think some hero control would be really good in that sense. You need to be able to slow them. It's a good alternative to the stun.
BKB also out on Bone 7 now, making his life a little bit easier. Also, level 16, Supernova at that point, where it's very hard to deal with for IG.
He's playing so well, man.
Yep. Burning, Heart of Tarrasque up next, it looks like. Vitality Booster in the inventory, quite a bit of gold to his name.
He's going hard first. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought maybe he would go Manta style here because it does give you more illusion options. If they find out which one's a real one, you can sometimes trick them again, but he definitely needs a lot of HP. At some point, he just has to go into the team fight and he has to say, I'm fighting until I die. It's a little dangerous to do that. But if he grabs a heart, it gives him a much better chance.
Well, the next push for C9 will commence. About 30 seconds left on this Aegis of the Immortal. Fata was very lucky last time, dying seconds before it despawned. Maybe
Mites
he can do it again. Luo turned into a piggy. Will take some damage, but does survive. Bone 7 uses the BKB.
That was a bit of a mistake, I think. I don't really know why he used that.
PL was going to drain his mana. Maybe he thought IG would initiate
There was no way that that was... I mean, what do they have for disables? Lion, I guess? Maybe is anticipating getting Hex Earthspiked, I guess, is one thing that's actually a real threat. That's actually a big threat, so maybe he was anticipating that. But it felt a little bit of a waste, and that's going to burn the Aegis, does it not?
Yes.
Yeah, it's gone now, so... I don't know. It's actually a Ultimate Orb purchase for TA. Is he buying a Scotty? Scotty Manta is really synergistic, but it's an item we never see on TA.
Well, we had a whole discussion yesterday about Scotty and the merits of it. Maybe a little bit too strong on this this version of Dota. So, honestly, at this point, I'm not surprised to see it come out on TA. I mean, why not?
It works. I mean, the hero does have some chase issues. Trap is good, but if you cast it instantly, it's only 30% slow. So there are going to be some good things about it. If he especially gets a Blink Dagger on top of that, he can jump into the fight and really chase somebody down. Like, a Zeus is going to die even through a Force Staff if he has a Scotty. Glimpse back on Zeus, actually. He's got a Haste Rune, but he's trapped in.
Yep, Kinetic Field, Static Storm going to be all they need. A Hex for good measure, and another kill for Bone 7. Secures his unstoppable streak. He's 9-1-11 this game, playing out of his mind on this Phoenix.
So what does he grab next? I think this is a good refresher game on Phoenix. Does he grab an Hex? Is there any value there?
We're going to see the rare... or Shivas as well.
There's no way it'll be Eggs, though. Eggs is so low impact compared to what else you can get for items. That's a Shivas. Shivas is amazing on this hero. Mm-hmm. There's other things, too. Hex is a good example, but he's already got it. So
Envy still finding some decent farm. Not the Scotty that you were talking about, at least not yet. He goes for the BKB first. Seems Cloud9 are really prioritizing magic immunity.
Okay. I think that's pretty fair, because any Zeus damage is going to be from that. This stops the mana burn for the illusions, so the illusions will do significantly less damage to him. I kind of would like to see him get a butterfly this game, though.
Scotty completed on Fada.
He's really recovered. He's done a great job. Really tough early game, but he made it work. Adjusted his skill build and items accordingly, and it's weird items, but it's great for pushing tons of HP, gives him more survivability for each refraction charge, and
I like the way Cloud9 are itemizing here. Big Daddy, after his Aghanim, seems he may just look towards a pipe. Has a cloak picked up already. A great item to have against the Zeus in a situation like this. A lot of magic damage in general on the side of IG, and will make things a little easier for Cloud9 in terms of sieging this high ground. The Tier 3 tower they've been chipping away at is standing at about half health as they continue to press forward in this top lane. They will deward the high ground there.
These are some good creeps, too. Alpha Wolf and the Granite Golem. It's 30% bonus damage. Plus 15% more HP, making the Scotty even more useful.
Here we go, the fight will break out. Bone 7, Icarus dive in, Ferrari's but doesn't caught. Use the Supernova yet. Ferrari in a lot of trouble. There's your Supernova. It's a dead Ember Spirit, and he has no buyback. He's in the grave for 80 seconds. The base could be in some trouble. Tier 3 tower taking decent damage. Still a glyph available for IG, but it's a 5v4 on the field. Granite Golem in the front lines. Envy just sitting on the low ground, laying into the tower.
The it's one lockdown weak. They needed.
Cloud9 playing this very safe, though. Not bum-rushing the high ground, but being cautious in case there was a buyback available here.
That Static Storm is so huge. That's the only disable they have other than the Hex, and he was able to catch him.
There's the glyph to try and keep the tower alive a little bit longer. They could possibly find a deny, but nope. Envy will find the last hit. Chuan getting slowed down by headshots. Thunderstrike giving them all the vision they need. Glimpse back, and it'll be a kill on the Lion. It's essentially a dieback for him. Buyback still on cooldown from the last fight. Now Barracks exposed without a glyph, a 3v5 on the field. Cloud9 should be able to claim at least one lane of Barracks off this. Things getting a bit sticky here for IG.
And Burning is doing a great job sending illusions in, trying to slow their push. It drains Fada's mana here. He's almost out entirely, but it doesn't matter. The melee Barracks goes down. They should be able to retreat from this one.
Mm-hmm. Range Barracks will stay standing, but Cloud9 must be very happy with that push. Now Big Daddy just about secured his Pipe of Insight. Things really coming together. And do we dare look at this gold graph purge? Now nearly 14k net worth, the lead for Cloud9.
They can still lose this, though. They've got to be careful. If some of these fights go too dangerously, it's going to be a lost fight. If Ferrari gets lucky crits when he does Sleight of Fist, it could be a lost fight. I really like the Fada build, though. This is the ultimate synergistic build in terms of illusions. Just buying stat items. Manta, Scotty, straight into Butterfly. You're giving your illusions tons of agility, which means they're going to do lots of damage. It increases his HP a lot, increases his armor a lot. It's very different than how we normally see TA be built, but it abuses the current popular items. And you throw snowballs. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh my, big item pickup for Misery here. That's your Aghanim Scepter, and one of these supports that often doesn't get that much farm priority, but if you can manage to get the Aghanims, it's absolutely huge. Now silencing inventories as well as hero spells. BKBs, not going to be so easy to use if you get initiated on by Musiri. Faith, he is in the wrong place at the wrong time here, sir. That's an easy pickoff for Cloud9. Roche 3 has respawned, scouted out by the side trap. There's also a remnant down. Both sides very aware of what's happening here. But this is Aegis and Cheese, and the ancient apparition in the grave. I'm not sure IG can really contest this. Could he possibly buy back? Is it worth it to stop third Roche from being taken?
I feel like if they do get the Aegis, them going high ground is very simple. I think it's worth it. He's so far away from Aghanims anyways. That
and of all the heroes to buy back, sit in the well and just lob a snowball. It's a good one for sure. Assassinate connects on 430, helps soften him up a little bit. Cloud9 actually don't commit to the Roche. They jump onto Burning. Bone7 with his BKB on, deep in the front lines. Fata caught by the Searing Chains. All heal from Cheng comes out. It is a buyback from the Ancient Apparition. Ice Blast only connects on Bone7. Bit of a chaotic fight, but Bone7 will go into the ultimate form on the high ground. Looks like Supernova won't stun anyone, but the Phoenix does live.
So they traded a buyback and an AA ult for a Phoenix ult, which is not the best here. They're looking about going back in. The Alpha ult dying is actually pretty significant. It's a 30% damage increase. He goes in, wants that wolf, and mech
it up. Mech'd up. I think the wolf will live here unless Ferrari can isolate it. They really want this Alpha wolf. How deep will they go for? Now the all heal from Chen, Big Daddy, giving them the proverbial
keep the wolf
middle
alive.
Finger there.
Anything. They might run here. Ferrari taking a big hit every time Sniper throws an attack.
He'll try to TP out. And he gets hexed. That'll interrupt it. Now glimpse back. Very short glimpse. Will jump to the Remnant. Gets another one down. 430. Will live, at least for now, on the other side of the fight. Fata isolated by Burning.
No tails. Probably dead there. No finger. ALT ice coming in.
Oh, could connect on quite a few. Big Daddy barely dodges it. Disruptor goes down, as does Bone7. Now Fata trying to reinitiate. Gets Hex straight away. Now stunned. He should fall here. Very tanky, but not tanky enough. He'll go down. Chuan survives. Right. It's a 3-0. This time it goes the way of IG.
So they finally win a team fight here. Some gold advantage going their way. And if they can take Roche, this is going to be
some
a huge
gold
advantage for them.
4K gain for IG and a 1,500 net worth loss for Cloud9. A huge swing, feeling the effects of that rubber band. And more importantly, they get Roche 3. That's Aegis and Cheese for Invictus Gaming, breaking this game wide open here at the 41-minute mark.
So despite buying back, Faith has now gotten an increase of about 800 gold. So completely worth it for him to come back. Even if the first initial ultimate didn't work out the best, it limited C9's teamfight potential, and they even used a mech and a Chen ulti just to heal the Alpha Wolf, which is completely not worth it there. If they had those spells in the teamfight, it might have been Bone7 staying alive longer. Maybe his Supernova was close to being up. Maybe they could have kept Fada alive longer or something like that. They burned all that just to keep the hard-to-find Alpha Wolf up, and they lost their subsequent fight, which got IG back in the game and guaranteed them a Roshan.
Yep. And they ended up losing that Alpha Wolf anyway once the fight died, so kind of
ooh,
all for nothing.
Lagging
it looks
a bit.
Like we're having a bit of a little bit of Kale on the stream. I don't know if that's just us or the game in particular. Still no pause coming out. Well, looks like we had some bad RNG with the server choice here, Purge. Unlucky.
So in terms of the gold gain, that's going to be huge for IG here. It's still a big advantage for them, but with only two or three kills there, they got a huge, that was like a third of the advantage that they were losing.
And we'll try to reconnect here. Looks like the server dropped. So stick with us here, folks.
Man, Cloud9's been playing so well today. I dare say better than everybody expected them to.
Mm-hmm.
It's looking very close to being able to take a 2-0. Obviously, IG making huge plays and getting some comeback here. They can definitely potentially win this.
I think a lot of folks out there expected Cloud9 to have a good chance against IG, a pretty evenly matched series, but it's looking a lot more lopsided than I certainly would have expected for either side, really. I mean, Cloud9 completely controlled game one, and up until that last fight, Cloud9 was really controlling this game. Still in a pretty good spot.
Yeah, they definitely are. They got the good hero compositions. They're building for items that scale pretty well into the late game. Fada for now can't do a whole lot with just Manta and Scotty, but as he finishes his butterfly and maybe gets a Daedalus on top of that, you're going to see his illusions do a ton of damage.
So having some trouble reconnecting here, folks. Of course, we'll get this game back going ASAP, but at the behest of servers right now. Everybody needs a hearty bowl of kale every so often, Purge.
That's really true. stuff is great for you. Just having trouble reconnecting the lobby. We definitely still have internet, so must be a Dota issue.
I would imagine so. Got some admins on the stage here, as we can see, talking to the teams, trying to sort the issue. I guess worst case scenario, we could always load from the replay. Never ideal, but better than a remake at 41 minutes into the game.
Definitely true.
Uh-oh.
Hopefully the Dota server did not crash. Fingers crossed.
Server was unable to locate the game session. Never a pop-up that you want to see.
Definitely true.
So how close is this game right now, would you say, Purge? If you could put some numbers on it.
I would say...
Still 50-50? Does IG maybe have...
I mean, before that last fight, I would say... Are you talking about that game specifically or the best of three as a whole?
No, this match specifically.
That match, before that little fight where they lost three heroes, I would say they had a good 80 to 90% chance to win the game. But with that fight, I'd say it's more like 70-30. It's still a pretty big C9 advantage, but there's definitely a real possibility that IG could come back.
Yeah.
They have better, they have really good scaling heroes, maybe not better, but Ember Spirit, in addition to Phantom Lancer, they're pretty dangerous in the late game, and the AoE coming out of the Radiant team isn't the best for dealing with PL. So if PL can be tanky, things get really scary.
Yeah.
And Ember Spirit as well can just delay the game until the point where PL does get scary.
Yeah, so. Ember Spirit is definitely one of the better heroes in terms of scaling with farm, one of the better Rapier carriers out there if it ends up going that long. Still has a long way to go before he hits that point. He had a Crystallis before we DC'd and was making strides towards the Daedalus, but I don't think he was too close to it. So we'll continue with our patience here, still waiting on an official ruling from the admin with how we're going to move forward from here.
Obviously, everybody a bit disappointed, but...
Yeah, we can admire the beautiful camera shots at the venue here, Purge, at DreamHack Bucharest. Some Bone 7 fans in the house. Hook them! Yeah, all right.
Does he even play Pudge?
I don't think so. Maybe it's a Clockwork reference.
Oh, yeah, duh. I'm stupid.
Derp.
You got me.
All right, so we've got a new lobby up here. I imagine we're just going to... Oh. Just got an update from our producer, but actually not really sure what he said. But we've got a new lobby up here. Looks like we will load from a replay.
I don't know how I am still managing to not remember the lobby password.
You've got the memory of a goldfish, young sir.
I really do. It's not a good sign.
Slow and steady as we get back into this next game.
We're definitely loading from replay here. Mm-hmm. As people are joining the slots, it's definitely the replay from before, so hopefully things are looking okay. Usually we get a couple small bugs to map positionings and creeps on the map and some cooldowns.
Unfortunately, Chen is actually one of the bigger problem heroes when it comes to reloads.
So he loses creeps, does he not?
Well, there's an array of things. I've seen in the past where it resets the counter of how many creeps he has, so if he had four creeps before, then he can grab another additional four and get that army even bigger until those initial creeps expire. Some weird kind of bugs like that. That one's a little easier to deal with. You just suicide the
creeps.
That's
a buff, man. Come on.
It is. It's a buff, but a bug is the word I'm using here. Usually heroes that have summons, like Lone Druid, tends to have some issues.
Yeah.
Sometimes there's funky stuff with the neutrals spawning in weird locations or running around.
I've seen that before.
Doing odd stuff there.
On the bright side, though, there wasn't a huge push coming. The team fight was resolved. Roshan has been taken. The team fight ended.
Hopefully.
So
we don't know what minute this is at to reload from. So hopefully Roche has been resolved and everything is clear. But
that's a really good point.
That's still a mystery until we load in.
They could actually get kind of screwed here. If the team fight where they just got three kills didn't happen, that would significantly hurt their chances of winning.
That is a big understatement, sir. That was a huge fight.
They're not going to chance that again. They will not force that. Be like, oh, wow, we actually just lost three heroes and a pretty sizable advantage that we had.
Yeah.
Bought them an extra half item or two.
I have some faith in the admins here to work out something that'll be maximize the fairness for both sides. We are reloading in here, folks. So fingers crossed everything will work decently well.
Just unfortunately one of those really rare crashes in one of the biggest games of the year.
A lot on the line here with IG behind and one loss away from elimination. Certainly so. We'll blame the spectators.
I'm not so good at reading IG's faces, but they look a little depressed right now.
Well, they're feeling the pressure. honestly, they tend to be pretty poker-faced when they're in a match.
All right,
so we're at the 42-minute mark.
Let's take a look. Aegis is not there.
Okay, so it looks like that fight did happen. And,
Ember,
well, we lose our
Aegis.
Gold graphs and whatnot.
We'll get him updated in a second. Cheese is on PL. PL is healing. It doesn't look like a whole lot was lost here. I think
okay.
there's still a dead TA. I think we're looking pretty much exactly where we were. There might be something that we're missing, but...
All right, we've been missing a couple of creep waves here, maybe.
Yeah. Sniper is finishing his Mjolnir. He's got a Maelstrom right now. Once he does finish Mjolnir, it's going to be very good against PL. One of the best anti-PL items. The only problem is that the Mjolnir itself doesn't work. You need the buff. Gank going on the bot lane, though. They're actually immediately fighting here. Faith is going to get blown up. Maybe Ferrari.
Supernova will go off. The finger finishes off the Disruptor. That'll make it a 1-for-1. Ferrari very low, but remember, he has the Aegis of the Immortal. It's IG on the aggressive now. Burning, joining the party, ready to fight, has a cheese in tow. Chen caught by the Searing Chains, hexed up. Big Daddy will get left behind. It's a 1-for-2, and IG strike hot after the reload. But up top, Chen creeps do a little bit of split pushing, and they get that ranged barracks. Not a very high-priced target, but it's still something.
Yeah, that's completely worth it there. Well, obviously you don't want to lose two heroes like this when you have a gold or when you have a gold advantage, but them getting the ranged barracks is at least going to continue to put pressure on the top lane. And again, IG has the best I'm Raxed and I don't care hero. It's Ember Spirit, but
yeah,
you know, any kills at this point are great for IG. They also lost two gems. Well, they lost a gem and IG lost their gem. Both were recovered by IG, so no gem now for C9. That'll lead to map advantage for them and a pretty scary position.
Yeah, so to recap items here, we'll keep our F5 tab open a little bit longer. Looks like the recent pickup, a Heart of Trask on Burning Daedalus is now up on the Ember Spirit. And looks like that's kind of the bulk of it. Also, Aghanim Scepter on the Zeus. IG will start to siege the high ground. All heal from Chen comes out nice and early. There is a glyph available for Cloud9, and they will easily repel this push. Not too much lost. Burning, though, continuing to farm very nicely. Purge, about 3,000 gold sitting in that bank account and closing in on 20K net worth, the leader at the moment.
So I'm a little unsure what he'll grab next. I feel like a Butterfly right now would be really strong because there aren't any MKBs ready on Templar Assassin or Sniper.
So they do have that Hex, though.
Yeah, it's a Butterfly immediately. The Hex is going to stop his evasion during the Hex duration, but this is a really cool timing. His damage isn't extremely high, though. Gank again. Misery's going to go down. IG is coming back, man. This game is getting even.
A quick one, yeah. Finger from Chuan gets things started. Looking at the gold graph, down to about a 5K net worth lead for Cloud9, and experience is in favor of IG. This game is strikingly even here at the 45-minute mark.
Yeah. It was very recently a one-sided game, but all of a sudden those three kills and then maybe C9 off the scope of the game. Sometimes when you have a pause that long, you forget what it's like, what are your strengths, how much advantage you have, the positioning of certain heroes, and bam, they start a fight bottom. It turns out to be bad for them, and now the game is close.
Envy split pushing up top, doing some damage to this tier 4 tower, gets it down to about half health with the help of the Chen army. He is trying to make his retreat now. Ferrari in hot pursuit. Shrapnel helping out Envy a bit, but they are on their way.
Oh, he's going to get caught, I think.
Oh, my.
I don't know if he messed up the chains or it was just a bit too late, but Chen creeps get healed. They send them back.
They almost get the tier 4 tower, 55 HP.
That was a bug there. He sent back his Chen creeps. It only pulled back the Black Dragon. Did he get his Ancient Golem? But it didn't grab the dinosaur
died.
Thing. It stayed. It didn't get sent back.
Yeah, and I think that's part of that bug where it no longer becomes... Chen can control it, but it doesn't really count as one of his creeps
or something.
It's very strange interaction with the reload.
So that's big because he lost his Granite Golem. He needs that thing. I think he had a Granite Golem there. But
he had a Granite Golem and a Lizard before.
Okay, so...
He's only got the
Dragon
side.
Now, and Dragon's one of the worst ones, with the exception of the fact that it's decently high armor. It attacks really slow and has a little bit of AoE. That's about
high HP also.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of a beefier.
There's better things.
Yes. The Lizard dies rather quickly, but if you can connect with the Slam, it does give you basically like a Thunderclap-ish mm-hmm. debuff, which
it
can
is
come in handy.
It is the smallest AoE, though. It's terrible. It's like one of the smallest.
Is it sub 100?
It's really bad. It's smaller than like... It's probably at least the same or smaller than the Tomato Creep.
The Hellbear Smasher, yeah. IG will go for the last remaining Tier 1 tower on the map in the top lane. Maybe they'll go for another one here. IG feeling that they've got a bit of momentum, want to continue putting pressure on. Still a cheese on for Burning, and Aegis of the Immortal is the inventory of Ferrari. Not sure how much longer it'll last. We lose our Roche timer when we reload, so could be expiring in the near future, but hard to say. Well, will be expiring in the near future, but when exactly, I'm not sure.
So IG's advantage is pretty much set here. I mean, it's not an advantage, but the game is reset completely. And at this point, I think it looks better for IG in the late game, personally. Like we said about before, Fada's item build still hasn't really progressed into anything really scary yet. It has some mobility, has some good taking the game and ending it advantages, but right now it's not doing that much, and it's not going to do... It's going to do almost nothing versus PL. I almost think he should have even gone like a Mjolnir this game, which is the most ridiculous TA item, but he needs they need a way to deal to clear the illusions very rapidly, or at least find out which PL is real and then kill him. Mm-hmm. And his items do not do that. He just gets completely overrun by PL. He needs more damage here, but way too much tank.
Yeah. 430, loses his Aegis, so it has expired now. He moves into Boots of Travel as his next item, but can start looking towards his next damage item. What are you thinking in terms of late game items for Ember Spirit here, Purge? Maybe we'll hold that thought as Big Daddy gets scouted out by Burning. Chuan's there to follow up. This will be a freebie on the Chen as Big Daddy hits the deck.
They also get Ember Spirit on the other side of the map, though. He does have buyback. That's a great trade.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ember Spirit should just build standard here. He can get a BKB, but it's a little tough because Static Storm doesn't stop.
So what is standard to you, Purge? Second Battle Fury?
I mean, I don't play the hero that much, but... Probably second Battle Fury before you get another Daedalus, I think. Because the Daedalus only gives you a higher... Well, it gives you plus 81 damage and gives you a higher chance to crit on each hit. If you get a Battle Fury and you crit... I don't know exactly where the interaction is, but I believe when the math was done, it's a double Battle Fury is the best. Mm-hmm. And with all the Chen creeps, there's lots of reason to say definitely get another Battle Fury. You're cleaving twice as much, and you're cleaving off all of these creeps. So I think a second Battle Fury is good, but he may just opt to go double Rapier right away. If he goes a Battle Fury and eventually replaces with Rapier, then maybe it's not the best call, but...
Yeah,
it's kind of hard to decide. There's a lot of things to take into account, but because there's few stuns, I think he should just skip BKB. Just go damage, man. Don't get ganked and get damage.
So for Cloud9, the team that was far ahead in this early game, they're one lane of barracks up. Now that it's about a break even in terms of golden experience, what is the play for Cloud9? Do you just wait for next Rosh and try to siege the high ground off that? What's the play?
Get an item that deals with PL and then go for a push, and there it is. The other thing to keep in mind is that with Shiva's finishing on Phoenix now, it reduces attack speed by 40, and the PL illusions actually have... All right, they're pretty decent on attack speed. He does have a lot of illusion. I was going to say he didn't have that many agility items, but with the butterfly, he's okay. But since he went for the fast heart, it doesn't give any attack speed to his illusions, just HP. His illusions basically don't attack that fast, and the Shiva's is really going to reduce the amount that they attack as well. So his damage is not amazing right now, at least until he gets something like a Manta. So I think... C9 might have an advantage here. Maybe wait till Butterfly finishes on TA as well, or get him an MKB. That might be better, actually. Skip the Butterfly finish, go MKB right now. It's hard to say.
Both strong items and have their individual merits. Ultimate from Zeus comes out. Will scout.
Will
the
he make it?
Positioning of Cloud9. Ooh, gets Fata tries to TP. Solid coming, but now will get locked down and brought down. It's Faith that'll get credit for that one.
Blink
he actually didn't
time.
Go for the Aghanims here. He went four staff. Made a stop off after that hand of Midas. It's a little surprising.
That's that bad of an idea, because there's a lot of BKBs at this point in the game, so him landing an Ags ulti is going to be useful for the Shatter, but it could be better, you know? I don't think this is terrible. It'll keep him survivable as well against the TA. If he doesn't have a 4 staff and TA gets close, he just dies. Same with Sniper. If Sniper gets it within range, at least he can force Sniper to be 600 units out of position attacking him than he was before. So I think Force is the right option, and it's also so much cheaper. Like, it's instantly useful. More HP isn't going to keep him alive against these carries this late in the game, but mobility and positioning will.
Chen has been so close to this pipe for so long here. He's just missing a big regeneration piece, that Ring of Health, and he'll have it. Trying not to reveal it by keeping it in the stash, but
that,
like,
one's
that
really
is a
important.
Big item for the team that they really need to prioritize.
That's something else that they should wait for the push. But it looks like they are finally just doing it. But unfortunately, IG is in a counter position, so IG should be able to take a tower if they don't defend this. Shiva's comes through, tries to stop Bone 7 from moving. But
Envy will just TP back right away. No split pushing. As soon as IG see the TP, they're happy to retreat and delay the push. Envy, oh no, he actually cancels the TP and lingers around in the bottom lane. But conversely, he sees IG TP back, and that'll
scary.
Be his retreat.
He gets spotted by the Zeus ultimate, but he also has vision on Rashan, so he knows it's up. This is something that becomes a little weird with the reset. Like you said, we didn't know when the timer was. It might have been bugged in some way. I've seen that happen before. Mm-hmm. So Rosh'an is up. Both teams know it, or at least the Radiant team
does. I think it seemed like it spawned at an appropriate time. It was on the faster end and the RNG factor, but felt pretty appropriate after that Aegis expired. This is Rosh number 4, so Aegis and Chi is available once more, and I think there's still Chi's lingering from the last one. Yeah, Burning, hanging on to it still.
So because C9 knows that the Roshan is up, they're looking to take a fight if possible. IG likely knows as well, though.
Certainly and suspicious there.
It is another battle fury for Ember Spirit here, unless he's making a Lincoln's. He's got his Perseverance. I was going to say Bloodstone, but you can't build that anymore. That was supposed to be a joke, guys. Yeah.
I think very likely to be the Battle Fury. If they wanted a Lincoln, someone like Chuan would be a much better target to pick it up and then apply the buff. He's got plenty of money to throw around and could actually grab it before too long here if this keeps up.
They do still have a smoke on C9 despite wasting that one, so they can still fight. MKB is finished on Sniper. TA nothing new, though. Still sitting on the Talisman of Evasion.
Does have a lot of gold pulled up, so keeping his options open.
He's got to save it for the buyback, mostly, though.
Ultimate from Zeus scouts out the positioning of Cloud9, and that should make IG pretty happy. They're in the Roche pit, and there's just no way Cloud9 can get here. This is a free Aegis and Cheese going the way of the Dire.
I guess C9 said, I don't think we can win Roshan fight unless we smoke for it. So I guess they're just giving up on Roche. They knew it was there. They're obviously not going to move from the position if they don't expect they can win the fight. So I guess they thought that they couldn't take the fight and decided to split, but I question that a little bit here. It's scary because IG does have really good team fight here. C9 is going to be peeking off because you've got a Disruptor that can maybe kill one person with his ultimate unless you get a God ultimate, which is difficult. Fada doesn't really do very much right now with the items that he went and him being a bit behind. And then, like, how do you kill the rest of IG's lineup? They have, like, five good team fight heroes with the Sables and the carries are a little bit stronger. So I feel like C9, it feels really trapped right now. They really needed to not lose those three heroes in the bot river and put them in this bad position. They needed to take a second Rax before things got dangerous.
Yeah, now it feels like Invictus Gaming really have control here. They've actually taken over the Golden Experience charts. The number is not so significant at this stage, but gives you a good feel for how the momentum has changed in favor of the Dire side. Double Ancient Black Drakes here for Big Daddy. As you mentioned, less than ideal for him, but he will have a set of Granite Golems that have spawned, so things will get little better for the Chen.
Yeah, you can't be that picky on Chen. The Ancients only spawn every 1 minute, and there's only one camp safely on the other side of the map, so if you got a Black Dragon, that's just what you're going to have to work with. Mm-hmm. And it's good to at least have the attack speed creep. The Hellbear Smasher will increase their attack speed by a bit, so they can push with that.
Yep, and the Toughness Aura on the Wild Wing Ripper does help out these kind of situations as well. Ice Blast flies down bottom.
Still no eggs for Faith, but he's close. More wards will go down. Eggs Refresher on Zeus as well, so that's a lot of magic damage. That's about to hit the Radiant team. They really need this pipe, but I'm surprised Chen hasn't been able to farm it. I mean, he can't leave his base very much, and he has been dying, but his creeps have been on the map quite a lot.
And they've just been giving all the farm to Envy. They're not prioritizing the pipe whatsoever. See a big wave pushing up top, and Envy clears it out straight away.
Envy has not used his BKB yet, by the way, unless this is a replay bug. Is there any BKB? We know Phoenix has used his ultimate. He's down to 6, so I'm assuming that it's tracking it correctly. I think he just hasn't used his
BKB. I don't
BKB
think he's
yet.
Used it. I'm trying to think of a time when I saw it, and I'm not sure.
Well, he's almost 6 slotted. Oh, he finds Burning, maybe? They pinged him. They probably think it's an illusion, though.
Quite possibly. And he does have a cheese, so
Ice Blast is
coming. They commit for.
They might chase this. Burning goes high ground, looking to chase.
Ice
A ulti
Blast
misses.
Will be off the mark. Zeus ulti gives him some intel. Ooh,
and a TP out as well.
Chuan almost catches Misery, but he barely makes it. Envy, Delta splits the other way.
He doesn't have a TP. This is pretty dangerous. He's going to get spotted by the creep wave, maybe. I don't think it's
on. It is nighttime. I don't think they saw him.
They're still moving up there. And yeah, Burden goes to farm, so they think he's... No, never mind. They're still looking. This is scary, man. His team's coming, though. This is really smart.
A lot of different places he could have moved at this point. IG will just let it go.
He uses Mjolnir. I don't like that too much.
Oh, that Dire Ward giving just a little bit of vision of Fata as he walks by.
Oh, they got vision
smoke
from
rotation.
The...
rotation. They want 430.
Glimpse
back.
Him.
Any time at the Hex is there. 430 goes
hero.
Down. That's the Aegis of the Immortal. He's coming back to life.
Ulti.
Can IG get in position? Static Storm's already down. Ferrari in a
look
lot of
damage.
Trouble. Big damage. He's dead. Instant buyback for him, but does he have any remnants down? On the small side of the or bottom side of the fight, Chuan, he's going to get isolated and brought down. Burning doing some decent damage here. Trying
Mjolnir
to isolate
buff.
Envy. He's backed up. Envy now hexed. He'll fall as well. Luo taking damage from Fata, but now completely sandwiched. What started as a good fight for Cloud9 will turn a bit disastrous as they lose both of their cores. They do force a buyback out of the Ember Spirit, but
PL is
know.
Just so strong right now. I mean, basically, Fata
oh,
did
two buybacks, actually. Chuan bought back also.
Okay.
Sorry.
Fata did almost nothing in that fight. He went after the Zeus, but he was hitting him like a pea shooter. Like, he only has stat items. His damage is limited, and he's not a Troll Warlord, so he doesn't have bashes. Misery and Trouble.
Caught by Chuan. All heal from Chen. Tries to top him off, man. But the Finger of Death is there. The gem hits the deck once more and goes back the way of IG. Actually, they don't even seem to care.
These Boots of Travel are so useful on these cores. Like, even if Chuan's there to set it up solo, if there's a creep wave even close, they're able to catch a hero. And TA buys back, but they need Eternal Envy to be up. He does have buyback as well, but he doesn't want to use it. He wants to delay it if he can, but it doesn't look like he's going to be able to. He's going to have to buyback, probably waiting for the team fight to start. But he won't be able to TP either. It's going to be running from the fountain.
He's just trying to avoid a buyback and then an instant IG retreat. They will use their glyph to delay damage on the tier 3 mid. IG committing fairly deep here. Shivas and Icarus dive across from Bone 7, trying to harass as much as he can. Tier 3 tower goes down, and Cloud 9 may just sacrifice this barracks and hold the buyback on the sniper. Looks like that
I
will be the case.
It. The one Rax here is not the end of the game. When it's 57 minutes in, he will be able to fight for the next fight and then buyback afterwards. If he buys back and then 5 minutes later he dies in a fight, the game ends.
They'll lose the tier 3. Envy up in about 4 seconds. They could lose two melee barracks here. No, IG just doesn't have the damage. They see the sniper coming up and they will back out.
It's tough though. Yeah, Disruptor's not up yet either.
So that levels things out. One barracks apiece this game. Going further and further the way of IG.
They should have won the last fight, but Ferrari had three lives with Boots of Travel, so, I mean, that's really tough to play against. They set it up perfectly, but maybe they used too much. They used Supernova and the Static Storm on his second life. Maybe that was a little... Maybe Supernova was a waste there. Maybe they could have won the fight if they saved the Supernova till the engage afterwards. Mm-hmm. But it's hard to not expect all of IG to jump in, so I feel like that was a decent read by Bone7, but IG just played it well there. So they lost the subsequent fight. They lose a Rax, they lose a tier 3 tower, but at least that's it.
Is that the second Heart of Tarrasque for burning? It
Are you
certainly
serious?
Is.
What? Okay. Is this the PL build? Just get so much HP. It's not a bad idea. I mean, Sniper's only got 2k HP, and burning has twice as much, and he's got 27 armor. It's not like his survivability is low here. If there was a Zeus or something on the enemy team, this would be really bad from Phantom Lancer, but considering it's all very static damage and Fada just doesn't have the items, this is a great choice. He's like, I have more DPS than you, so I'm just going to get a huge HP lead. And a lot of times when your DPS is equal on the two enemy carries, like, you want to continue to get DPS hybrid items, but because their DPS is low, he can just buy hearts.
Well, Ferrari does end up going for the Lincoln Sphere, but he waits till after that second Battle Fury. I guess opting for the Lincolns instead of the BKB in this scenario. Finally, as we roll over to the 60-minute mark, Big Daddy finds the gold for his Pipe of Insight. Talked about how big of an item pick it is, but at this point, is that 400 damage block really that scary?
It's still worth finishing. I mean, he had all the items finished.
Course,
it's going to keep his creeps alive. It'll at least block part of a Zeus ult. And considering they're getting hit for 1,280 magic damage, it'll make a dent. It's 400 HP for his team, basically.
Okay. IG being a little cautious here, just trying to starve out Cloud9. Very aggressive wards coming down, so they can try and find pickoffs as need be. Looks like Misery was able to recover that gem that he dropped. There are three gems in play right now, two on the Dire, one on the Radiant.
I'm just thinking about the Scotty again on Templar Assassin. It was so good for that top push, but as soon as that push fails, the item becomes pretty bad.
Seems like he will take heed to your advice, though, and just hold the Talisman and move right into an MKB. If he didn't have to buy back there, probably would have had the MKB completed already.
Yeah, the Butterfly would be good, dealing with the Ember Spirit, maybe, and the Phantom Lancer, but they have enough nukes and damage that the evasion wouldn't really do that much to keep him alive. He just needs Butterfly and MKB here. I think that's the only thing he can do for building. His item progression just hurt him a little too much here, I think. And he's kind of turned into not being a carry anymore. He recovered really nicely, but you know, the way the fights continue, the Scotty just hasn't done anything.
Yeah. Eternal Envy still farming very well. Soon to be level 25, and a lot of gold on him. Curious where he'll go with his next item choice. Burning, BOT's up to the top lane. Envy very isolated here. We'll just TP home. No way for Burning to interrupt him. But you see how much damage Burning can do. Gets him down to about half HP, and just a couple of swift auto attacks.
The other good thing that the double heart does is, since Mjolnir's an AoE item, but it's magic-based, that means it doesn't continue to scale. So the double heart is going to make the Mjolnir even worse. So their one and only way to deal with the illusions is basically even worse off. I think I don't know what he'll get for his last item. Maybe even something like an AC might be really good, because the extra survivability he'll get from it is going to be ridiculous. It doesn't do that much for his illusions, but maybe an Abyssal Blade would be the right item. He could just chase people down, stun them.
Yeah.
It'll help him deal with the sniper. It's just looking like an IG, a really big IG advantage right now, I think.
Yeah, Roshan will be on the later end in terms of respawn timers, but is there any way that Cloud9 can even get out of their base to really contest if IG opt to move into the pit when the big boy respawns?
It's tough. They're going to have to get a good smoke initiation. It was a Lincoln Sphere here for Ember Spirit as his fifth item. Cheese in his inventory, which he will probably later sell. I think it's a little dangerous for him to go Rapier, though.
Definitely.
Because there are good heroes for killing him on C9 with the Disruptor ultimate now.
And as we saw in that last fight, he was locked down and
he got
killed right away.
There's a Hex. They killed him there, and then when he respawned, they had another ability to use on him. They did a really good job holding that. A lot of people just blow everything, like, kill him, but he had an Aegis, they knew that, so they saved it.
Cloud9 still locked in their base, look at their vision, and they do not have much. Templar Assassin Traps giving them that little tiny bit of intel, but gems are making things easy for IG in terms of clearing out what would normally be a vision advantage for Cloud9 in this kind of a situation.
And C9 doesn't feel very comfortable leaving the base. It's a 90-second we-know-where-you-are ability out of Zeus, so as soon as it was used, all of C9 retreated, and they're just going to move 5 now, and that's probably the only thing they can do. They have to check high grounds, look for wards, and get control of the map, and hopefully a kill for them. It's looking bad, though. AA's even really farmed now. 3,300 gold for him. Their Midases have completely paid off here.
Yeah, 63 minutes in, the double Midas is definitely paying some dividends.
What does AA even buy here? Does he make a Yule Scepter or something? Maybe a Hex, a Shiva's Guard? I don't know. Blink Dagger wouldn't. Blink Dagger's pretty bad on AA. I don't think that does much. But
I think Hex could be okay. Having some additional lockdown, never bad.
Yeah. It's just a little too expensive for his gold pool, I think. And there's no guarantee that he'll continue to get gold, so it's a little scary.
Maybe a Vlad's could be good here. Get some Aura Lifesteal for burning.
That's a really good idea. Five armor is going to help his whole team. That's definitely worth picking up.
Certainly has the money for it.
C9 just doesn't feel comfortable leaving the base here. And they again spot them out using an AA ult, so IG will continue to farm 3, 4, 5 heroes across the whole map. They'll continue their gold advantage here. And this is looking worse and worse.
Cloud9 running out of options. They feel so pressured to just stay in their base and make sure someone doesn't get caught out.
Yeah. You guys might be wondering, why are they just sitting in their base or not doing anything? But They know that IG likely has wards on the map, so if they move across the map, they're going to get spotted. If IG, since IG has a teamfight advantage, if they have also vision advantage, they're going to start it off right. It's almost surely going to be a wipe. So C9 has to pretty much wait until IG comes high ground, and then they have to wait until they overextend.
Yeah.
Although,
a bit atypical of Cloud9 to not have vision control to scout things out like a Roche at this timing of the game, but they just don't have the vision tools. No Zeus, no Rocket Flare, and IG will use one of the Thunder God's Wraths just to see if Cloud9 are making any kind of movements towards the pit. Of course they're not. That will be yet another Aegis and Cheese going the way of IG. Ferrari picks up this Aegis, and Cheese goes to burning. He'll drop his drums in exchange for a block of Cheese.
Yeah, so they have two Cheese and an Aegis. Talking about the double heart again, I actually think it was a mistake to go two hearts. Why not go heart Scotty? It gives you 250 less HP than a second heart would. And it gives you 25 agility, that's 4 armor. It gives you 25 strength instead of 40 strength, and it gives you 25 int, not to mention 150 mana on top of that. Like, there's like almost no reason to go a second heart over a Scotty, unless you're like, I think 250 HP is the difference. But what about your 25 damage, 4 armor, 25 attack speed? Heart would have been better, or a Scotty would have been better as a second item. The heart
is there any
the
kind of a bad interaction with Diffusal and Scotty?
It doesn't interact
works
anymore.
Fine.
It's completely fine. Getting a Scotty on PL is arguably, in some situations, better than even the first heart. So going to second heart, there's no reason it should have been
right.
Scotty. It doesn't matter that much because the heart is still in a really good place. The idea is that he just wants to live. So.
Okay, IG grouping up in the top lane. There's no tier 3 tower to defend this lane of barracks. There is a glyph, kinetic field slowing things down a little bit. PL sending in some illusions just to start chipping away at the range of barracks. IG will slow siege this and play it very carefully, putting Ferrari in the front lines, of course, as the Aegis carrier. They'll be happy if he's the one that gets initiated on and possibly even brought down first in this exchange. Burning, pressing forward, does get slowed down, taking a fair bit of damage. Ultimate from Zeus coming out. There's your all heal from Chen, picking his team back up. Barracks being
Ferrari?
Defended pretty well. Ferrari almost goes down, but will live. Aegis still in tow. A good hold from Cloud9. They do have to use the glyph, though.
And BKB on Eternal Envy. As the double Zeus ult came in, He got a little worried. The A ulti almost caught him. It was very, very close. But I like the itemization that Eternal Envy went this game. He sold the Sanjin Yasha, and he picked up a Daedalus, which is an item he definitely needs. Again, all these HP items that Burning bought means that his damage is still mediocre. His HP is high. So to counteract that, Sniper's not going to be able to outlive a PL, so he has to buy more damage to compensate. So sell the SNY late game, get the Daedalus. It drastically increases his damage, and he's much more likely to be able to kill Ember Spirit in 5-6 hits.
Well, Burning ate his cheese in that last little skirmish, and that opens up a new inventory slot. He'll take heed to your advice, sir, and Skullbasher secured. Looks like an Abyssal Blade will be on the horizon once he has enough gold for buyback as well as his next purchase.
Yeah, so not too unexpected. Just needs a stun. Phantom Lancer is actually more of a melee hero in some ways than an illusion hero now. You do still want illusion items, but you can also get melee items like Scotty Abyssal Blade because you're charging so much, you're in the battle, you're fighting stuff. Already taking some hits here.
Bone 7 caught by Searing Chains, but he'll get mech'd up. Ice Blast will connect on Eternal Envy. BKB has cooled down. It's an 8-second charge that he still has available.
Oh, man, look at the damage. He's going to have to jump back.
Taking a lot of damage and will Remnant back to safety.
Now, Misery could maybe be aggressive and go for the Static Storms. Whenever he uses Sleight of Fist, he can't move essentially for 0.2 seconds per hit. Might be able to drop the Static Storm on top of that and go for the kill, but he does have Aegis. If that works, they won't be alive after. Burning's actually
Burning
in a lot of trouble
here.
Taking
a lot of damage here. Bone 7 in the front lines will get brought down. He has a buyback available after the finger. Now Ferrari will get killed. That's the Aegis of the Immortal.
I think this will be him dying. We're going to have a Static Storm here. Here comes. Nope, not going to use it. He didn't have Kinetic Field, so he couldn't guarantee the kill. It just would have stunned him or silenced him for a few seconds there, and they're back into it.
They go right back for the barracks. IG, they want a second lane, and it looks like they'll find it. Melee have gone down. Range, the only ones left standing. All heal from Chen. BKB used by Envy as he squares up against Burning. There's your doppelganger. Goes on to Big Daddy. The Chen in a lot of trouble. Locked down as Burning gets another. Kinetic Field comes out, but is it enough?
Bone 7 bought back. TP'd in aggressively, but decided to come back anyways, and they're going to pull Burning back. This might be his death. We'll see. Couple hits on him. 4-second doppelganger, and he does go down. So they do get the Burning kill.
Much needed. Of course, Burning does have plenty of gold for buyback, so not a game-winning kill. They still lose their melee barracks in the top lane. Certainly less than ideal for Cloud9, but they live to fight another day.
That wasn't too bad for them. Melee barracks at this stage against a team that's stronger than you for a carry is not horrible. But again, PL's not scaling amazingly at this point. He went for his HP advantage. It's kind of similar to what Fada did here. He's like, I'm going to get a lot of HP so we can win the next fight. But the fight didn't work out. And his damage is not going to scale amazing. And there's the Rapier purchase on Ember Spirit. This is getting really scary. He has no slots for Cheese. He has no slots for Aegis. If he dies in a fight and Sniper picks that up, drops like Mask of Madness or something like that, I think it would be worth it to drop. His movement speed would be a little slow, but with a Rapier and a Daedalus, that's two items that stack really well. He could actually three-shot heroes
easily. Are you thinking this is the right call from Ferrari at this point? It feels like a slightly
dangerous.
Unnecessary risk to me. Yeah, because he has been locked down. We've seen he is killable in these fights. He probably would have died in that last exchange if the kinetic field was available. But so now he needs to be very cautious with his positioning.
Juan get pulled back.
He'll get glimpsed back up top. Uses his Ghost Scepter.
That was a great Zeus ult. It stopped the blinks for the follow-up there. And they're looking for him. Wow, he's already back in the base there.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
it is. Or staff blink, that'll do it.
It is dangerous, but the same vein goes. If he gets lucky on a Sleight of Fist when Cloud9 gets a little too grouped and he crits twice on a hero cleave, you could just see somebody die. And then the push is over. They're not going to push with that. They'll go back to their base and they'll delay the game. So as long as he adjusts his positioning, maybe lets PL take all the pressure and then jumps in for Sleight of Fist, it could work out fine. And he just has to make sure that they don't get a Hex into Disruptor ulti and he's not going to lose it.
All right. Well, things continuing to progress here at the 70-minute mark. Very even game. It's amazing how the scales have tipped. Cloud9 had about a 15-20K net worth lead maybe half an hour ago, but it's IG now with that massive net worth and experience edge. Regeneration. As they are now totaled up in their base, trying to figure out what Cloud9 may do.
Well, Vado's been farming really well, actually. He's got his Monkey King Bar, finish and 4K gold on top of that. So, again, he's more of a tanky fighting hero, which isn't good against PL, especially because his cleave is in a line and PL will swarm around him, but he's getting to be a little dangerous now. IG's going to have to be a little careful. Meldstrike especially is going to start impacting fights because he's going to feel a lot more confident initiating. So, we'll help kill in the PL. Butterfly Daedalus is maybe his item build here. Butterfly definitely first. I think Daedalus will be okay on him. If he gets the Rapier as well, that'd be really terrifying.
Mm-hmm. Faith is going for the Refresher Orb on this Ancient Apparition. You'll see this pop out from time to time. Double Ice Blast can potentially be game-winning if used appropriately.
Good. You can kill two cores with it, basically. You don't necessarily... It'd be great to land an AoE Ice Blast, but you can't really gamble on that. Most of the time, you're like, oh, that Sniper's stunned. Kill him. Mm-hmm. And then you can refresh, use it on the next hero.
Absolutely.
Going in.
IG, smoke out of the base. It's Eternal Envy that gets jumped on, but Static Field, Kinetic Storm is there. The Ice Blast brings him down. Envy will buy back instantly. The fight taking a couple of different turns here as Bone7 makes it to the high ground. IG looking to find a few more kills out of this. Big Daddy not making it out of this one. Tries to TP home, but Ferrari catches him.
Good and attempt from him, but...
No buyback on Big Daddy.
If there was still Dota 1 nighttime where the creeps were asleep, he would have made that there. Because the only reason they knew is there was the attacking. Chuan again grabs another hero. It's Sniper. This is so bad. If he goes down, that's going to be an easy high ground.
It's a dieback for Envy. Out of the game for 2 minutes. And this could be a GG play here. Lua will get brought down by Fata. The Supernova goes off, and now Burning joining the party, squaring up with Fata. Kinetic Field comes out. Fata low on mana, now starting to run low on HP. He gets caught by the Searing Chains. He'll go down as well. He's out for a while, does have a buyback, uses it straight away, but three heroes in the grave. Bone7, he could be in some trouble also. That's it. GG is called. And we're moving to a Game 3 decider.
Wow, IG comes back from a huge deficit. Maybe that reset with the downtime gave them some mental stability there to come back into the game, and I felt like C9 lost some focus there. They got those three kills right before the pause, and immediately after, they took another fight where they went 2-for-1. They came back into the game, and then their carries scaled better into the late, so that was what they were waiting for all game, and they collected it, and they barely squeezed out a win there. I really felt like that was going to be a C9 victory there, but... They lost their focus, and they didn't quite itemize correctly, in my opinion, and they didn't take the win.
Yeah, Cloud9 had control for pretty much the first half of that match. They broke that top lane of Barracks, played very cautiously, and it just didn't work out. So unfortunate to have a DC in the middle of the game like that. You make a really good point that it does kind of break up the cadence. When you come back, you're just a bit disoriented with where were we, where were they, what was the last movement that I was making, and... Seems like it did cost Cloud9 at least a little bit in that game.
So we're back to the ace match.
Mm-hmm. It all comes down to a best of one.
Hopefully Cloud9's not too shattered by that one, but I think they can definitely still take it based on their first two performances. They won game one. Game two was easily winnable. Maybe not easily, but certainly winnable.